Blackstone Audio presents Fatal Undertaking by Mark de Castrique. In memory of my father, Arch, whose funeral home stories brought Barry to life. Chapter 1. You want to borrow a casket? Archie Donovan leaned forward, his eyes bright and his brain disengaged from any concern that I'd find his request ridiculous. Only the last 2 weekends in October, then you'll get it back as good as new. But it won't be new. I got up from my armchair, anxious to move both the conversation and Archie out the door of the funeral home. People don't buy used caskets. Archie seemed unperturbed. He pushed his proposition like he pushed his insurance policies, oblivious to any objections. You have my personal guarantee, Barry, and who's to know? Is it violating some lifetime warranty on the casket? His brow furrowed as he thought about his question. Can you have a lifetime warranty when the owner's already dead? For you, I'll double the lifetime warranty, and I'll even put you in the casket myself. Archie looked up at me, his eyes wide with surprise. No need to get mad. I thought you'd want to help. Susan said we could count on you. Susan? The name of my girlfriend got my attention. The Jaycees are raising money for the children's wing of the hospital. Don't you care about sick kids? Of course I care about sick kids. Ask another stupid question like that and I will get mad. I returned to the chair across from him. Susan hadn't mentioned anything about the Jaycees fundraiser. I wish she'd warned me before Archie's unannounced visit. He had a knack for punching all my wrong buttons. We'd known each other since grade school, and he was always figuring out an angle, whether it was a scheme for my lunch money or a can't-fail investment in a cemetery. Susan came up with this idea? I asked. Archie beamed. I did. What better than a casket in a haunted house? Maybe he had a point. But when you'd grown up in a funeral home, you were sensitive to jokes about the business. I never forgave Archie for calling me Buryin Barry in the third grade, a name that stuck through high school. The Gainesboro Jaycees were creating a haunted house for Halloween to raise money for charity. Apparently this year, the funds were going to the hospital, where my girlfriend, Susan Miller, worked as a surgeon. I could see I was fighting a losing battle. If you joined the Jaycees, Barry, you'd know what's going on in town. I know enough. More than I want to sometimes. The secrets of the dead, of the living. Remember, I'm also a deputy. I got up again. And I'm on duty in an hour. Archie stood and offered his hand. So, we've got a deal? I'll check with Fletcher and Uncle Wayne, but yes, we can probably help. He pumped my arm. Great! What are you going to do with the casket? Someone will be lying in it, and then when people come up close, he'll sit up real fast and scare the bejesus out of them. You want to volunteer?
No.
And keep where you got the casket a secret. Archie laughed.
Where else would we get it? Walmart?
He jabbed me on the shoulder.
You kill me, Barry. You really do.
There certainly were times when I wanted to. A full month later, I stood at the edge of a cow pasture and watched a line of cars turn off Stag Hollow Road where the blue flashers of my patrol car marked the entrance to the Gainesboro Jaycees' House of Horror. Orange-vested volunteers waved flashlights to direct vehicles over the bumpy ground and into makeshift parking spaces. Archie Donovan and his committee had rented the Bradley Farmhouse, a piece of real estate that had been on the market for 6 months without a single offer. The old widow Bradley passed away in early spring, and none of her children wanted to move into the home place, a weathered structure that saw its last renovation when Eisenhower sat in the Oval Office. Sheriff Tommy Lee Wadkins had assigned me Halloween night duties. He knew I had no children to take trick-or-treating, and I'd be here anyway since Susan manned the ticket table at the foot of the front porch steps. The site was about 3 miles from Gainesboro. Not so far that...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.